In last class, we have discussed on design of fillet weld, whereas in this class, we will be discussing on design of butt weld. Okay, so we will take an example. Okay, so here I am taking an example that is a 18 mm thick plate is joined to a 16 mm plate by 200 mm long butt weld. Okay. So this is the problem, right? We should find out the strength of the joint. Okay, what will be the strength of joint? That means how much load it can carry. In two cases he has given two case, one is a double V butt weld and next one is single V butt weld. Okay, so it is butt weld means we are connecting two plates of size of thickness 16 mm as well as another one is of 18 mm. Okay, as you can see here. Okay, we are connecting two plates. Okay, face to face. That means this is butt joint. Okay, and we are doing a groove weld. Groove weld, in groove weld we have two types. One is single V and double V. Okay, single V means welding from one side, whereas double V, okay, welding from either side of the groove. Right. Okay, so first we should know the parameters which is given. What he said, assume that Fe 410 grade plates are given, right? He mentioned that Fe 410 grade plates are given and sharp weld is used. Okay, you know very well, when it is a sharp weld, the factor of safety gamma mw will be equal to 1.25. okay, as we discussed in last class, right? So we'll solve a problem. First, we'll solve problem on double V butt weld. Okay, as of now, we must know the guidelines also. So earlier, when while calculating effective throat thickness, we have taken in a fillet weld, we have taken values around 0.707. Okay, so whereas TE is equal to 0.707, yes, we have taken in fillet weld. Whereas here it is, effective throat thickness, while calculating effective throat thickness in butt weld, he has given a guideline in 10.5.3, clause number 10.5.3. The effective throat thickness of a complete penetration butt weld shall be taken as the thickness of the thinner part joined. Okay, especially this clause is applicable when a double V butt joint or double bevel joints we are using. Okay, in that case we can go for this. And that of an incomplete penetration butt weld shall be taken as minimum thickness of weld metal common to the parts joined and excluding the reinforcement. I'll tell you how to calculate, right? Okay, first we'll solve double V butt joint. Okay, in double V, what he said, the effective throat thickness will be equal to thickness of thinner part joint. Okay, so there are two plates, one is of how much, 18 mm thick, another one is 16 mm thick. Okay, and width of the weld should be how much? Okay, whatever the length of the weld is restricted to 200 mm long, right? So what I'll do, okay, effective length of weld directly given, 200 length is available. Okay, so we joined it by 200 mm. And thickness of weld, how much? T, effective throat thickness, how much you have taken? TE, because of this clause. Okay, when it is a double V butt joint, obviously the effective throat thickness will be the thickness of thinner plate. Among these two plate, which one is the thinner plate? Okay, it is 16 mm. 18 mm is there, another one is 16 mm. So we should go for 16 mm, right? So we got length of weld as well as effective throat thickness. We know Fu is given in the problem, so assume that Fe 410 grade plates and sharp welds are used. Okay, Fe 410 grade, we have taken Fe 410. Okay, and gamma mw, sharp weld, it is sharp weld, so we are taking 1.25. so effective area of the weld is how much? Effective length into throat thickness. Okay, now the design strength, earlier we have used the equation. Okay, using that we can easily find out the total strength of weld, right? So lw is the same equation which I am using. Okay, lw is length of weld 200 mm, thickness is 16 mm, fy is grade of plate, and root 3 into 1.25. it is there in root 3 equation, is there in, okay, IS 800. Okay, it is of fillet welds. You can use the same equation, right? So we have written LW is 200 mm, T is 16, Fi is 410, root 3 into gamma MW, factor of safety when the welding is done at shop. Okay, shop welds are used. He has mentioned in the problem, right? So I am taking this one. So when you do a double V butt weld joint, okay, when you connect these two plates using double V butt joint, okay, its strength, the connection strength will be how much? 605. You calculate yourself and check it once, and it is around 605.98 kilonewton. This is the first case, right? And next one, okay, I think you understood the problem, right? Simple, the equation is there, only the substitution part, right? When it comes to the second case, what he said, a single V butt weld is used, okay? So only the difference is that same equation is will be used while calculating effective throat thickness. Okay, here you can see, okay, the penetration is, the effective throat thickness is very less. Here the effective thickness is how much? Okay, the total weld size is more than the thickness of plate, but effective thickness will be how much? Thickness of thinner plate. Okay, here you can see, right? In a single V, the effective throat thickness will be very less, whereas in double V, effective throat thickness will be more. Okay, so that's why we have taken effective throat thickness in double weld is equal to thickness of thinner plate, whereas here it is less. So it will be calculated, it will be calculated in this manner. So I'll take second case, that is the strength, we are finding the strength of joint using single V butt weld. Suppose if you do single V, okay, if we do welding on only one side, so what will be the strength of that connection? That we should find out. Okay, earlier it was if we do welding on either side of the connection, so it will be how much? 605.98. whereas here it is when you conduct only one side welding, when you do a welding at only one side of the connection, so what will be the strength of that connection? Okay, that you should find out. So here effective throat thickness of single V butt joint is T is equal to 5 by 8 times the thickness of thinner plate. 5 by 8 times thickness of thinner plate. Okay, so what is that? Thickness of thinner plate is how much? One plate is of 18 mm, another one is of 16 mm. Obviously, which one is a thinner plate? Obviously, it is 16 mm will be a thinner plate. Okay, so I'll be taking in effective throat thickness of single V butt joint is how much? TE is equal to a T or TE, whatever, right? 5 by 8 times the thickness of thinner plate. Okay, it is around 10 mm. Okay, only this one is the difference between single V and double V butt joint, right? Okay, next, we'll substitute the values. Only the difference is earlier length of weld in weld available is how much? 200 on both the cases. Only difference is that in double V will weld on either side, whereas in single V, how much it is? Only one side welding is done, whereas width of plates are 200. Okay, width of plate. Okay, here we can see. Okay, here the width of plates, whatever the width of plates are there, okay, you suppose if it is 200 mm, okay, in double V we made welding on either side, whereas here it is only from one side. From bottom we are not doing any welding, right? Okay, so here you can see only one side welding, from one side a groove will be there and welding from one side. Here it is welding from one and two. Okay, two sides welding will be done. Okay, so effective throat thickness, here it is 5 by 8 times 16 in single V butt joints, right? Next will be 200 into 10 effective throat thickness. Fu is same, root 3, and this is factor of safety. Gamma MW is factor of safety, that is 378.74. Okay, when you calculate, the strength of weld is how much? 378.74 kilonewton. When it comes to a double V, when you weld on both the sides, okay, the capacity of that connection will be how much? 605.98. Whereas when you connect it at only one side, so the capacity of that connection is 378.74 kilo Newton. Okay, yeah, this is all about the design strength of butt welds or bevel joints. Okay, single V and double V bevel joints. Okay, when you are connecting face to face, that one we call it as a butt joint. Okay, whereas the welding is done in two manner, one is single V and double V.